the icons, and I think we will do this with, I will import some icons so I can show you also how I import icons. So first I go into flat icon. Do you know flat icon? Oh no, flat icon, it's a pretty cool page where you can just download some icons and use them in your design. You have, I can search now for icon, which icon I want to search. I think I will search for Hurt. And yeah, now you can see, you can also go premium, because some of them icons, for example this one, you can't use this because you're not premium. But yes. Or maybe a cup is better because we are selling coffee right in this picture, so we need some coffee things. And I think this is a cute one. I will download it as this one. And then I need some, maybe we find some coffee. Oh, pretty cool. Yes, this was great. And we need another one. We can add something like, oh, maybe buy. Yes, that's cool. That's really great for our extension. Now I go into Fontello. Do you know this page? Someone of you? Except from Daniel and Luca and the others of my company, because they already know this page. Oh, I have already some custom icons here. I will all put them out, and then I can just upload my icons. You can see here 3 icons, and yes, this looks great. So now I can download my web font, because now we created a font which we uploaded on our project, and then we just can use our SVGs like a font. And that's pretty cool, because you can change the size and make some color in it. You have more possibilities, instead if you just uploaded it as a as a picture. And yes, so now if I go back into my downloads, I have also this config JSON, and this is important if you want to add some more icons later. You just drag this here, and then they will just put all your icons which you have already uploaded it here again, so you can add more icons or delete something. And yes, then I have our font. I will first name it into, like, every icons I name them EMZ icons. I know I'm pretty creative. This file we don't need, because it's now I have the icons in, and then we go back into the other folder, and we need this. We just need to open this, make here another folder, and this one we'll call components, because in Jobware you have modules and you have components, and in components there are all less files which are used. So first I also need a components file. And then I can import my file fonts, because we just want to create a new file which is called fonts. And yeah, wrong Yes, now we have our funds and now we can implement our Fontello file. So now we want to use this font face into our file. And first I will call this not Fontello, I will call it AMZ icons. And here I have to use the right path. And yeah, now this would be working. Nice. So it's also important that this code is on the end of the font face, because this is the ID, I think, of the Fontello things. I just understand, I just noticed every time I'm deleting this code, then the whole font face is broke, so don't touch it. And now I put all in. So now that we have the right, we just can do it here. And then we have our icons, and I will cancel first. I'll first go this away because I don't like if this looks like this. I think I can also do this for a little styling before. And also I will put here an AMZ, because the problem is now when we use this code and just don't use the AMZ, then he will also put it on the icons which are already from Shopware uploaded. So we just add the AMZ, so we say that it's for just only our icons and not for every icon we have. And yeah, take this icon and put it here into my box. I copy it. Oh, damn it. Yes, now. But of course, it needs to be looking. So if I compile this, there will be, hopefully, the icon. But I think it should be. Whoa! It's working! And now if I put a font size, for example, a little bit bigger, you can see my icon as a font! Woo, that's cool! And what is also cool? You can just add now a color. Oh, fuck. Yes, and yeah, you can, I can now make it also red, and you can, yeah, make it really simple responsive.